I'm Janneke. I'm 25 years old. I live in the Netherlands. I'm a spontaneous girl who likes to go out. I love walking. I like to go out with friends on festivals and have a beer at a bar. But there's also a side of me that's not also active. I can't always think straight. It's because of the MS. And it gives me problems with mobility, balance, all sort of things. And most of those things are invisible for others because they see the happy me and they see this. So a lot of people don't know me as the Janneke with issues. They know me as the active person. But that's also a side I have to live with. Well, on my bad days, sometimes it's hard. Most of these bad days, I try to think of everything I still can do. So I'm happy I can go out. And even when I'm not walking, I can sit and I see the people who I want to see and I can talk to them. Or just give them a call and I can tell my story, and that gives me energy to go on. I had bad days and bad weeks, and everything sucked. But I got more angry at myself and at everyone, and everyone was telling me from what's going on with you? This is not you. So that made me think about what I was doing to myself and what I was doing to others. So that's the moment when I realized, okay, I have to do something about it, and I have to enjoy my life much more than I did before. The first couple of months, when I needed to use my mobility aid, it was very difficult. I didn't want to use it. I used my bike, for instance, as my mobility aid, because I could hold on it and I had grip to not fall and have some balance. But a bicycle isn't always a good thing to use. You can't take it everywhere. It took me a long while to understand that it really helped me out. And that realization is a good thing, because now I have my freedom back and I can do the things I love, because I'm not persistent anymore. I think the mobility aid is become part of my life, just like riding my bike is. When I need to go for grocery shoppings, first I did it on my bike, and now I do it with my rollator. When I have a rough day and I'm a bit weak, then my rollator is awesome, because it gives me strength to just relax and walk through the grocery store. You have to stay open-minded, and that's a good way to help you to stay positive, because when you are not open-minded, that all those possibilities fall apart. Well, I started with a rollator, and people looked at me weird things. What do you do with it? Have you taken it from your grandmother? A lot of times. I also went to a bar with my rollator, because I couldn't walk that easily and I knew I had to drink a few sips, so it would stabilize me a bit. But then the bartender, he looked at me very funny, and then he said, okay, you're not welcome here, because you use a rollator and it takes in too much space. We don't want you here. And then I said, yeah, but look at me, how I take these sips. I can make money for you. And he just sent me out, so we went to another bar and there was no problem with it. But people always have an idea about it. They don't think twice before they yell something at you. So there's a lot of different scenes that came by. People yell at me, people say things. some people think I use it to get attention, but that's not true, of course, but they don't know better. It's more embarrassing for them than it's for me, because I know why I have it, and I know that they don't know about such things. They just don't know, and that's something you have to accept. When I work with this modern rollator, I get less yelling. People are now more just stopping and looking. And the grandma thing I haven't had anymore, so that's a good thing. Most of the reactions I get now with this modern rollator is how it looks good and how fashionable it is. Yeah, I don't have to dress up anymore because now I have this modern fashionable rollator. I wanted to give my other rollator away, but it was too emotional for me because it was my first one. So now I use it for my plants. It's a staircase where I can put my plants on. Emotionally it's still with me, but I don't use it anymore because it's too heavy, it's too uncomfortable to walk with. And this one just gives me so much more possibilities. Before my diagnosis, I had no trouble walking. Everything was fine. And then the diagnosis came and suddenly I couldn't be able to stand, I couldn't walk. So that was the first moment the physical therapist told me to use a rollator. My grandma had one, so I took hers. But it wasn't my own choice. I had to take it because the physical therapist told me to. It took me about 2 months to realize I really needed it and to make it my own choice to use it. Because when I used it, I could do much more things than without using it. I was able to go out with friends again. And when I didn't brought it with me, I could not see my friends because I was too tired. So in a way you can say I became more active because the use of it. Because it just gives me a piece of freedom back. I can do the things I want to do because I know in my mind, okay, when I have a busy day, when I go to the zoo with my family, I don't always need it. But when I don't take it with me, I can't take my rest moments in the zoo, and those moments I am not able to talk with my family. And when I choose to take it with me at the zoo, I have all the time to talk with my family because I can sit down. I can take a rest moment and I have time over. It's an other way of spending my time, and it uses me to stay active and do the things I love.